So this video will surprise you because you don't expect what I'm going to say. What am I saying? Anytime you are about to arrange a recurring meeting, don't do it. Stop doing that. Create a team, add a channel, and do all the recurring meetings there. Yes, this sounds very revolutionary, different. You have never thought about it, but trust me, this is the best way. Let me explain why. You have done hundreds of recurring meetings in life. What happens in the recurring meeting? Every month, quarter, whatever, that meeting entry is there in calendar. Okay. But what happens during the meeting? Minutes of meeting, the action items, collaterals, discussion, follow-up. Is that happening in calendar? No. Where is it happening? Oh, in that best friend of yours, you're dumping round number one inbox, right? So you want to avoid that. That is why I'm saying do not create recurring meetings in regular calendar, because calendar gives you a place for calendar, nothing else. Whereas if you do it in Teams, you get place for not just the meeting, everything around the meeting. So mails reduce and clarity improves. So create a team. Let's say I have a review meeting. I'm going to create a team called review meeting. Nothing in my calendar right now. Then I have a channel called general. Now you have two choices. Use the general channel. In any channel at the top right corner, you have new meeting. In that also, you can have recurring meeting. So just create that recurring meeting there. Job done. Now, when you create the recurring meeting, there is a problem. You have added all the people who are supposed to be a part of that review in the team. Very good. Now, where is that meeting? And you can see it posted in the channel. But if I go to my calendar, I don't see the meeting. And that's what is very confusing. So when you create a channel meeting, it does not go to the individual calendars. Now, how will it go to my calendar? Because if it's not in the calendar, I will not come for the meeting. Others will call me for another meeting. Agreed. So the idea is simple. When people are in a channel, they're supposed to come and look at the channel or what is going on in this context, this topic, periodically, at least once a day. So when they see the message, so there is a meeting arranged. Now what do I have to do? You have to go there, double click on it and say add to my calendar. Once you do that, it will be in your calendar and now it's a regular kind of meeting from a reminder point of view. So go to the channel, new meeting. In that, there is a recurrence option. Go to this dialog and you will realize that this is similar to what we have been used to in recurring meetings, which we are creating in Outlook. So you have yearly, monthly, daily, same thing. The difference is it's now a part of a channel instead of your regular calendar. But now the benefit is every meeting which happens, the meeting recording, the transcript, chat associated with the meeting, collateral files, whiteboards, all of that is going to be in that channel. Nothing is going to go to mail. So all the follow-up activity, all the tracking activity, one place. One problem here, because I've told you that if there is a recurring or single meeting, action items now are available directly as loop component, right? You get notes. In the notes, you get agenda, notes, and action items. Unfortunately, at the time of creating this video, loop components are not available for channel. So you have two choices. Use planner, which gives you a list, delegate it to each other, and that planner list continues across meetings. That's number one. Otherwise, you create a workspace page, loop workspace page, and then add the URL of that page as a new tab, as a website in that channel. But in either case, this is better than doing recurring meetings the way we are doing today. I know this is a very big change. We have never thought of it like this. So try it out on a test meeting. Convince yourself and your colleagues and then implement it across the organization. Now, loop is a very powerful feature. I already have a couple of videos. Have a look at them. Try this out and let me know if you have any queries. So that's it for now. Thank you.